jumping off the porch like mom's not home. Tell me why the best things feel so wrong. Summer nights, love them how they take so long.
What's up guys, it's Josh and we're back again with another video. So I've been doing this little series now for a while where at the beginning of each semester at Yale, I take a moment to kind of fill you guys in on what classes I've chosen to take for the semester. I'm like 3 weeks in the class right now, so I have a pretty good idea of how the classes are going, share with you guys like what I'm interested in, what topics they're covering, and just kind of fill you guys in on my life, because that's what I like doing on this channel. And you guys seem to like these videos, so I thought I would keep it going. For those of you that don't know, my name is Josh Beasley. I'm a sophomore at Yale University studying electrical engineering and computer science. My channel mainly consists of Yale vlogs, sit-down videos like this. Sometimes I do some college application stuff. If any of that sounds interesting, feel free to subscribe. You definitely won't regret it. And with that, I will start getting into what my course schedule looks like for the semester. All right, so as I said, I am a electrical engineering and computer science double major. So the core of my schedule is going to be computer science and electrical engineering classes, and this semester is no exception. So I'm actually taking two CS classes this semester and then one electrical engineering class. So my first CS class at Yale is titled CS223, which is the second kind of required class in the Yale computer science core. The title of the class is Data Structures and Programming Techniques. So as the title suggests, it is the Data Structures CS class at Yale. The language that it's taught in is C, which you gotta love C. For any of you CS people out there, I've done a little bit of work with C, but basically C does not do anything for you at all when it comes to like programming. This means you have to literally, anytime you want to allocate memory on the heap, you actually have to physically write a command to allocate that memory. Nothing's dynamic. You got to make it dynamic yourself. And then you have pointers. Pointers are just, yeah, it's a lot to deal with, but it's going well so far. So we're going to be covering, you know, linked lists, hash tables, stacks, queues, all the useful data structures that I'm going to need for the rest of my CS career. Super excited about it. It's been really interesting so far. Maybe I'll fill you in on some of the projects and piece sets I've been working on in the blog, so check out those. And yeah, so far CS223, pretty good class. So the second CS class that I'm taking this semester is CS202. It falls under the CS department, and I mean, it's a required CS core class, but I wouldn't really call it a CS class. It's actually a discrete math class. It's titled Mathematical Tools for Computer Science. So far it's just kind of been like a little sampler of a lot of different topics in mathematics. Luckily though, I did take a proof-based linear algebra class last semester, so most of the proofs so far have been a breeze, which is really good. Other than that, that was pretty good. Last class we started talking about set theory, which is a pretty cool like area of math that I haven't really done a lot of work with. So I'm excited to see what else we cover throughout the rest of the year. All right, so those are my CS classes. My third class is Electrical Engineering 202, which is titled Communication, Computation, and Control, which is kind of the prerequisite to these big like signals and systems class. Although we don't dive super deep into signals and systems. In fact, we don't dive super deep into a lot of stuff. It's kind of a very broad class. Similar to CS202, it's kind of a sampler of a lot of different topics in electrical engineering. We started off, so far we're talking about like Shannon's like information theory. We've done like Huffman coding, like the Kraft inequality, if that even means anything to you guys. Basically like compression, data decompression, like how, like when you take a picture, how is the data compressed? Is that compression lossy or lossless? Stuff like that. It's pretty interesting and it has a lot of applications to stuff that I actually do in real life, considering that I'm like a photo video guy. So the class has been just honestly really cool so far. I know we're going to be talking about like the internet and networks and how like stuff talks to each other. Like, I'm excited. It should be a good class. And it's a great continuation from the computer engineering class I took last semester. All right, so that's pretty much my core STEM classes. The other two classes that I'm taking are not STEM, which is really good considering I took four like heavy STEM classes last semester. This semester it's nice. So my fourth class is Intro to Architecture, which is the first like required architecture class for the architecture major, but most of the people in there are not architecture majors. It's only offered to sophomores, which means there's no first years in the class, which is kind of nice too. But it's a pretty cool class so far. I've like never done any architecture stuff like that before. I've never really delved too deep into like the arts, I would say. Like I hated art class in elementary school. I sucked at drawing, I sucked at all this stuff. Well, now I'm in a class where all the assignments are drawing. So the lectures, which are unfortunately at like 9:25 Monday and Wednesday, not a huge fan, but the lectures are actually really interesting. So far, we've talked about like structure, we've talked about surface, just like looking at buildings from different perspectives each week, and like walking around Yale where like the architecture is so diverse and beautiful. And now I'm just like, it's kind of like given me like a different perspective on like why buildings are the way they are and like how everything in a building has a specific function and what that function is, which is really cool. Like I said, all the assignments though are drawing. So each week we have a drawing assignment, and then Friday we have a section where we meet and we all like kind of lay down our sketchbooks and we discuss the assignment, discuss like why we chose to draw things certain ways. And you're like, Josh, you just said you couldn't draw. And yes, I cannot draw, but I'm working on it. I'm getting better. My drawings have definitely improved in the last 3 weeks, and we'll see where I'm at the end of the semester. So my fifth and final class is titled Law, Technology, and Culture. It actually falls under the CS department, but it's a social science credit. Me as a CS major, I've always been kind of interested in like the actual like policy and like law part of like computer science. Like obviously with tech evolving and everything, with law has to catch up, and like what laws still hold, like what, how is technology changing the nature of law, is just kind of like a cool question that I've always been wondering, and this class kind of addresses that. We've studied a lot of court cases so far that involve technology. Professor's amazing. I have nothing bad to say about that class so far. It's really kind of, so far it's taught me to kind of think in a different way. When it comes to, like, I've never taken a law class before, so the fact that I kind of just jumped headfirst into this one, it's pretty cool. The lectures are really good and engaging, and like the readings are always super interesting, and like I just really have nothing to complain about with this class. Definitely one of my favorite like lectures that I've taken at Yale so far, and yeah, I'm interested to see the other cool stuff we talk about and read for the rest of the semester. All right, so that's about it. Those are my five classes for my fall semester of my sophomore year at Yale. I know a lot of you guys were curious about like what exactly I was taking, so glad I could fill you guys in. That's about it for this video. If you enjoyed this video, if you learned something about me, feel free to drop a thumbs up down below. It helps me and supports the channel a lot more than you think and allows me to keep putting out these videos. If you have any questions, comments, concerns, future video ideas, suggestions for me, drop them down in the comments below. I will read them all and try to respond to as many people as I can. If you're new to the channel and you haven't subscribed yet, what are you doing? You're really late to the train, so do that ASAP to be notified when all my new videos come out. And with that, I guess that's about it. I will see you guys in a couple days with another video. Can you hear the drumming?